Just before 11 p.m., October 15th, Cleveland police are called to the corner of East 12th Street and Superior Avenue downtown. Officers are met by a terrified 31-year-old woman who tells them she just escaped from an apartment in the Reserve Square apartment building. According to a police report, the woman tells officers she is from The Gambia in Africa and was sold to a family in Kuwait, where she spent the last 4 years as a laborer to take care of an elderly sick woman. She says on August 12th, the family brought her with them to Cleveland so the grandmother could get treatment at the Cleveland Clinic for an unknown medical condition. The woman says she never had a chance to escape because, quote, the family locks her in the bedroom. But around 9:45 that evening, they leave and she is able to get out. Investigators say the woman first contacted a victim advocate in Arizona, then made a report with the National Human Trafficking Hotline before she contacted Cleveland police.
I am so glad that there is enough awareness out here that she knew who to call to get help and that the people she called responded appropriately.
Renee Jones is president and CEO of the Renee Jones Empowerment Center, which offers services to human trafficking victims in Northeast Ohio.
Some people may have seen her, didn't know, but these things are real.
I spoke to a security guard here at Reserve Square who says when he let officers into the apartment that the woman says she was being held in, it was vacant and smelled like hookah or flavored tobacco.
The woman told officers she feared for her life and did not want to go back to the family or the Gambia because they will kill her.
That's pretty scary.
Now, Cleveland police did help the woman find a temporary place to live, but they also say that while they were taking her to that location, that family had called her several times on her phone. Right now, police say they are still investigating.